running. I'm just waiting on a few more people while I still run my logins. Good morning, everyone. Come on and let somebody know that we are on. I did make it known that Mondays are becoming a bit late. Good morning. Cecilia, good from Zambia. God bless you. Zambia. Good morning, everyone. Share. Only 3 people have shared. If you have not shared, share it now. Share. When you come on a Woman or Man of God's Life podcast, it's been a blessing to you. Unless you don't have a genuine heart, it's been a blessing to you. You always share. You just press the share button and that's it. Somebody share the video before we start. Hallelujah. Happy Monday to everyone. We are about to start now. How is everyone doing? I hope you're all enjoying the weather. Good morning, Flourish. Good morning, Mary AM. Good morning, everyone on YouTube. Good morning. Thank you for sharing, Matilda. You're gonna learn to share. When you come on, you share. When you come on, you share. Some of you are here because somebody shared, even though it took you 10 months to join, but eventually you joined anyway. So that is how it is. You keep sharing, one day the Holy Spirit will touch them to join. So somebody just share the video. We are about to pray. Is somebody ready to pray? Commanding your morning is all about praying, decreeing, and declaring. Hallelujah. Because there is power in your decrees and there is power in your declarations. Whatever you want God to do for you, you got to learn to decree it and declare it. You've got to get to the place of, you know, enjoying prophetic declarations and allowing it to come out of your mouth. You've got to speak what you want to see. The Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. In other words, whatever you want to see happen in your life, God is saying, I want you to speak it. I don't want you to complain. I don't want you to pick up the phone and start talking to A, B, and Z. I want you to start confessing what you want to see happen in your life. Some of us curse ourselves more than we bless ourselves. Some of you think, how? Some of you curse yourself more than you bless yourself. Oh, I'm not going to make it. Oh, I'm give up. I've given up. Or if it's going to work, it's going to work anyway. You get what I mean? Nothing good comes out of your mouth. You're confessing evil. You're confessing sickness, you're confessing poverty, you're confessing lack, you're confessing shame, you're confessing this disgrace. Anything that you talk about most, you're praising it. Yeah, anything you find yourself talking about all the time, you are praising that thing. And so some of us, we praise our problem more than we praise God. Why? Because we talk about our problem more than we talk about, you know, the God that we serve, more than we talk about the things that we want to see in our lives. So you gotta say to yourself, this year 2022, even though we have a few months to go, like the year just flew, I'm gonna make sure from this month, August, to December, I'm gonna speak what I want to see. I'm gonna speak what I want to see. Even if I'm confronted with darkness, I am going to see light. Even if I'm confronted with sickness, I'm going to see healing. Hallelujah. I'm going to see good health. Whatever you see, it is only a matter of time you will possess in the name of Jesus. And so we're going to start today with thanksgiving. That's what we do on Commanding Your Morning. Anytime we come on, we thank the name of the Lord. We thank God for the gift of life. We thank God for His grace and mercy. We thank God for His unconditional love towards us. We thank God for His protection. We thank God for grace. We thank God for His unconditional love towards us. So in the next 1 minute, I just want us to lift our voices unto God. And just thank God. Somebody lift your voice. Thank God that you are still alive. Thank God that you are not dead. Thank God that He has protected you from every plan of the enemy. There are some things that the enemy has plotted against you. He's still plotting in the realms of the spirit that you can see, but God has saved us from them all. The Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God delivered us from them all. There are battles that He has saved you from that you can't see. There are victories that He has literally put in your hands, but you can't see. There are traps that God has set you free from and allow you to escape, but you can't see. There are so many things that God is doing that we can see because it's got to do with the spiritual realm. And so today, I want us to forget about the pain that we're going through. Forget about the battles that you're going through. Forget about who is hating on you. Forget about who is fighting you. Forget about the witches and the wizards right now. And you're going to just lift a voice of thanksgiving unto God because your praise would usher you into your breakthrough. Am I talking to somebody? Your praise can usher you into that healing. Your praise can usher you into that open door. There is power in thanksgiving. And if you can be a child of God that is full of gratitude, your tank would always be full. Hallelujah. So never allow what you're going through to stop you from giving praise, to stop you from thanking God, to stop you from lifting a voice of thanksgiving unto God and just saying, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless your name. Lord, I exalt your name. Lord, thank you for keeping me alive. Lord, thank you for protecting me from evil. Lord, thank you for protecting me from shame. Lord, thank you for protecting me and my family. Lord, thank you for protecting my marriage. Lord, thank you, oh God, that I'm still alive. So long as you are alive, there is hope. And so somebody, I just want you from the bottom of your heart, just lift your voice and say, thank you, Jesus. Somebody, thank God this morning. Somebody, thank God this morning. You've been complaining, hey, Harriet Cavallo, it's good to see you. Somebody lift your voice and just thank the name of the Lord. God has been good. God has been good. God is good, and God will continue to be good. If it wasn't for God on my side, I'm going to speak for myself. I'll be dead and be 6 feet under by now. But His goodness has kept me. His gentleness has kept me. His mercies has kept me. It is not by my doing. It is not because I am righteous. It is not because I am holy. No. It is only by the grace of God. And so I'm thanking God this morning that His grace has kept me. I'm thanking God this morning that He's got my back. Yes, do I go through battles? Yes, I went through battles. I'm still going through battles, but I will never stop thanking God because I know that God will take me out of that battle. I know that whatever I'm going through is not going to last forever. That pain, it is for a moment. And at the right time, God would perfect me. God would establish me. Am I talking to somebody today? It is only a matter of time. And so let's just thank God this morning. Thank you, Harriet. Let's just lift our voice and just thank the name of the Lord, for He is good. You don't just thank God because He has done something for you. You don't just thank Him because you have a testimony. You don't just thank Him because He's answered your prayers. You thank Him because He is God. You thank Him because He is good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for protection. Thank you, Jesus, for provision. Thank you, Lord, for just your unconditional love towards me. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for calling me your daughter. Thank you, Father, Lord. Thank you for the air that I breathe. Thank you for my family. Thank you for giving me shelter. Thank you for allowing me, oh God, to walk around, to do around, to smell around, to see around, to taste around, to hear around. Not everybody is fortunate enough to have the senses. Hallelujah. But God has given you eyes. You can still see. You can still smell. You can still breathe. You can still hear. You can still walk. Am I talking to somebody this morning? Be a child that is full of gratitude in the name of Jesus. Amen. Prophetic decree number one. Good morning, Gabriel. Prophetic decree number one. I shall not see shame. Somebody decree and declare this morning, I will not see shame in the name of Jesus. Whether we like it or not, there is shame being cooked in the realms of the spirit for you and I. But because you wake up every morning and you decree and declare that you will not see shame, shame will be far away from you. And so we're decreeing and declaring this morning, according to the book of Romans 10:11, that we will not see shame. Shame will not come near us. Shame will not knock on our door in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare this morning, I will not see shame. Somebody decree and declare this morning, shame will not come near me. Somebody decree and declare this morning, shame will not come near my home. Somebody decree and declare this morning, shame will not come near my family. Somebody decree and declare this morning, I don't want to know shame. I don't want to see shame. I don't want to experience shame in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree this morning that you will not see shame in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number two, this year I will mount up with wings like an eagle. I will run and not be weary. I will walk and not faint in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare this morning that you're going to walk this year and you're not going to faint. You're going to run and you will not be weary. Somebody decree and declare you are mounting up with wings like an eagle. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 40:31, But they that wait on the Lord, there are blessings in waiting on God. God is saying, I will give you supernatural strength. God is saying, I will give you supernatural speed. I will make sure you are never tired. I will make sure you are never weak. Because when you wait on me, there is provision made available for you. And so we're decreeing and declaring this morning that 2022, we're going to mount up with wings like eagles. We're going to run and never be weary. We're going to walk and not be faint. We are commanding divine speed upon our lives and divine strength upon our lives. A lot of you on this live broadcast, you are tired of life. You are tired of living because it's like nothing is moving in your life. You are at a standstill. You're going through life. You're going through circles in life. It's from one thing to another. And you're getting to the point of giving up. And God is saying, so long as you're waiting on me, I'm going to give you strength. You will not be weak. You will not be weary. Hallelujah. And so we're decreeing and declaring this morning, divine strength and divine speed is our portion in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number three, 2022, my path shall shine brighter and brighter. The Bible says the path of the just is like a shining light that shineth brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. And so we're decreeing and declaring that our path will shine brighter and brighter in the name of Jesus. We're decreeing and declaring this morning that our path will shine brighter and brighter in the name of Jesus. Your path will shine brighter and brighter. It's not going to shine today and be dim tomorrow. You're going to see where you're heading. You're going to see where God wants you to go. Nothing would block you from moving forward. Nothing would hinder you from moving forward. God is saying your path is made clear. There shall be no hindrances. There will be no obstacles in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody decree one more time, my path will shine brighter and brighter in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number four, I shall arise and shine, for my light has come. Now, when I'm decreeing and declaring, one thing that keeps me going, even though, you know, this has always been, I believe in declarations. But I remember when Hare Cavallo gave her testimony when she was coming back to USA after her vacation. She missed her flight and she stood there. She was at the airport and literally decreed that I'm leaving this airport, that whatever happens, I'm going to leave this airport. And God had his her declarations. And what happened? A flight that was parked, somebody had to come down for her to get it. What are you talking about? There is nothing like I have been speaking and God is not answering. God answers prayers. God hears every prayers. You got to decree and declare, this is not a ritual or this is not a spiritual anthem. This is not something that we do because we just do it. No, this is something that we do because we have the revelation of what it means to decree and what it means to declare. So as you're decreeing and declaring, see it manifest. Don't just decree because I'm decreeing and you're repeating. Believe what you are saying. And once you believe it, it shall work for you. Hallelujah. So we're decreeing one more time. We will arise and we will shine. Somebody, is your season to shine. Somebody, is your time to shine. Somebody, is your time to rise. You've been down for a long time. It's your time to get up. You've been crawling for a long time. It's your time to get up. You have been on the low for a long time. It's your time to get up. You have been in the dark for far too long. It is time for you to shine and be seen. People that are meant to help you in life, they can't help you if they can't see you. And so some people are walking around life, but they are not visible. Spiritual surely they are covered. But today we're decreeing and declaring, God is saying your time is come. It has come now. It is now. It is not going to come. It is not about to come. God is saying it is now. Can you rise up and shine? Can you stop hitting yourself on the head and blaming yourself for the mistakes that you did 100 years ago, 50 years ago, 20 years ago, 10 years ago, 5 days ago? You're still hitting your head. You're still blaming yourself for mistakes that you have done, and they're pushing you backwards before instead of forward. And God is saying, rise up. Rise above the limitation. Rise above the battles. Rise above the warfare, because I want you to shine. God said, I want you to arise and shine. You got to be intentional about your destiny. You got to refuse to be a nobody. You got to refuse to be at the same spot year in, year out, and say to yourself, I am rising and I'm going to shine. You are not just going to rise, but you're going to shine in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, I shall arise and I shall shine. Somebody decree and declare, it is my time to rise and it is my time to shine. Nobody is going to dim my light in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 5. No darkness shall overtake me. No darkness shall overshadow me. Somebody decree and declare, you will not be overtaken by darkness. You will not be overshadowed by darkness. Somebody decree and declare this morning, oh God, may darkness not come near me. Anything that is not of God is dark. The Bible says God is light and in him there is no darkness. Anytime you go through a situation that is not in the plan of God for your life, you're going through a dark situation, you're going through a dark patch, you're going through a dark destiny. Because whatever it is that you see happening in your life is not of God. A sickness upon sickness, affliction upon affliction, battle upon battle, poverty upon poverty, lack upon lack, bad news upon bad news. That is not the plan of God for us. He says, the plans that I have for you, that are of good and not of evil. Plans to give you a future, plans to give you hope, plans to give you an expected end. So when I see the opposite of the plan of God for my life, I know that the devil has come in. And so I make sure I fight until I win, because I've got the power to win. Hallelujah. Because I am a victorious child. I am a child of a God that is victorious. Hallelujah. And so we're decreeing and declaring that darkness would not come near us. The Bible says in Isaiah 61, which I read before, arise and shine, for your light has come. Your light is here right now. Rise up and shine. Hallelujah. And so we're decreeing and declaring that darkness would not come near us. We would not be overshadowed by darkness. When you're overshadowed by darkness, you can see what is around you. When you're overtaken by darkness, you can see what is ahead of you. And so we're decreeing and declaring this morning that we will not be overshadowed by darkness, and we will not be overtaken by darkness in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 6. No weapon fashioned against me shall prosper. Somebody decree and declare, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon. When the Bible says no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper, it means weapons will be formed against you. It means people will gang up against you. It means people that you have helped will turn against you. They will put their weapons together to destroy you, to bring you shame and disgrace, to destabilize you. But God is saying, let them go ahead and form their weapons. It shall not come near you. Let them go ahead and form their weapons of mass destruction. It will not come near you in the name of Jesus. And so somebody, I want you to decree by faith that no weapon of the enemy that is formed, about to be formed, going to be formed, shall ever prosper against us in the name of Jesus. It went on to say that any tongue that will rise up against you in judgment, the tongues are condemned. Some people are in the habit of cursing people. Some people are in the habit of lying on people. Some people are in the habit of destroying others, pulling people down. And God is saying that whatever they decree from their mouth against you is saying, I have condemned it in the name of Jesus. And so we're decreeing one more time that no weapon of the enemy, no weapon of witches and wizards, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon from the kingdom of darkness that is formed against me, about to be formed against me, going to be formed against me, shall prosper. And any tongue, kabasike le mayata, any tongue that has ever risen against me. Some tongues have risen against us before even we were born, when we were children. And those things are fighting us. But we're decreeing and declaring today, because there's power in declaration, that any tongue that has ever been risen against us, any tongue that has risen against us, about to rise against us, going to rise against us, any evil, satanic, demonic tongue, today we mute them permanently. We mute their tongues permanently, that no word that comes out of their mouth against our lives will stand in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 7, I will enjoy the covenant of exemption. There is a covenant of exemption for you and I. There's a covenant of exemption for the children of God. And God is saying, I want you to enjoy the covenant. I don't want you to just hear about it. I want you to enjoy it. There's a difference between hearing and enjoying. You can come from a family that is rich, and there's an inheritance for you. You can hear it, but you might not be able to access that inheritance. And God is saying, I just don't want you to hear that I have a covenant of exemption for you. But I want you to believe it, and I want you to enjoy it. And so we're decreeing this morning that we will enjoy the covenant of exemption in the name of Jesus. That we will be exempted from struggles of life. We will be exempted from problems of life. We will be exempted from battles. We will be exempted from shame and disgrace. We will be exempted from problems. We will be exempted from calamity. We will be exempted from accidents. Somebody, can you hear me this morning? You got to decree and declare, I shall be exempted in the name of Jesus. I am exempted from every form of trouble in the mighty name of Jesus. Some of us would have died in COVID-19, but the blood of Jesus exempted us. Chicken pox is going on, but we shall be exempted in the name of Jesus. Am I talking to somebody this morning? We shall be exempted in the mighty name of Jesus. That whatever it is that is cooking, we will exempt. We are exempted, and we will continually be exempted in the name of Jesus. Not just us, but our whole household, our children, our husbands, our family members shall be exempted in Jesus' name. Somebody's probably saying, not my family, they're wicked. I won't pray for them. Prophetic decree number 8, I will enjoy greatness on every side. Somebody decree and declare this morning, you will enjoy greatness on every side. Somebody decree and declare this morning, you will enjoy greatness on every side. The Bible says the gentleness of God. Not the gentleness of man, not the gentleness of your brother, not the gentleness of your mama and your dada, not the gentleness of your husband or wife. It is the gentleness of God that has made you great. You didn't work for it. You didn't have to fast for it. You didn't have to pray for it. God is saying, I've made it available for you. In other words, I want you to be great. I don't want you to be a nobody. I don't want you to be a non-entity. I want you to be a somebody. I want you to be somebody that will leave a legacy for your children's children. That even when you die, you will still be remembered. Hallelujah. And so we're decreeing and declaring that we will be great on every side, and we will enjoy greatness on every side. You've got to be that great mom and great dad to the point where when you go, the greatness is still in your children. Your children are still benefiting from your greatness. Hallelujah. You don't want to live a life where your children would blame you in 20 years' time. You want to live a life where your children, after 20, 30 years that you have gone, they'll say, oh, thank you, mommy. I thank God for the life of my mother and my father, for setting the pace for me where I don't have to struggle. I don't have to fight the battles that they fought. Hallelujah. Because you have dealt with all the battles. And so your children just come and sail through. Hallelujah. And so somebody, there is greatness in the inside of you. It doesn't matter who is looking down on you. It doesn't matter who does not believe in you. It doesn't matter who sees you as the black sheep. Listen, let me tell you something. God said in his word, in Psalm 18:35, that my gentleness has made you great. It is not about to make you great. It is not going to make you great, but it has made you great. Hallelujah. Where is Margaret Cavallo? I have a word for her. A word just dropped from Margaret. Is that her name? Margaret. Margaret Cavallo. Prophetic decree number 9. God will supply all my needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, my needs shall be met. God is saying that I have riches in heavenly places. I have everything that you need. I, God, I have everything that you need. And I'm ready to supply whatever you need. I'm ready to supply your needs. You see, God has made it so clear. He didn't say once, because we can do without once. But he's saying your need, the things that you can't do without. And so God is saying that I shall supply. And so I've come to let somebody know, I don't know what you need. I don't know how long you've been needing what you need. But God is telling me to tell you that he's going to supply your needs. He says, I will supply all your needs according to my riches in glory in Christ Jesus. And so we're decreeing and declaring this morning that God will supply our needs. There is a need that you have. There are needs that you have. And so somebody, I want you to mention that need one by one. You are in your own closet home. Even if you are in your room, even if you are in public, you can murmur it in your breath. That Lord, supply my financial needs. Supply my marital needs. Supply my healing needs. Whatever your needs are, can you mention it today? And ask God to supply, because his word does not go back to him void. He said, whatever I say I will do, I will do. And when you remind me of my word, I am a God of integrity. I will make sure that I give you what you need. Hallelujah. And so one more time, somebody, decree and declare that, oh God, may you supply my needs in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 10. God shall satisfy me early and show me mercy. Somebody decree and declare this morning that, oh God, satisfy me early, oh God, and show me your mercy. Satisfy me early, oh God, and show me your mercy. The mercy of God is such that it's the good that you don't deserve, but you get. That is what mercy is. Mercy is the good that you don't deserve, but God gives it to you. You don't deserve it, but God said, take it. If it wasn't for the mercies of God, the sins that we have committed, from when we were teenagers to the age that we are in now, like we are at now, if it wasn't for the mercy of God, some of us will be burning in hell right now. But the mercies of God has kept us. And so we're decreeing this morning that, Father, in the name of Jesus, satisfy me early and show me your mercy. You don't need no late satisfaction. I don't need a late satisfaction. I need a timely satisfaction, a divine satisfaction. I don't need a delayed satisfaction. You don't want to be 92 before you marry. You don't want to be 90 before you build your house. You ain't going to enjoy it. Somebody's going to come and enjoy it for you. When we talk about early satisfaction, we're talking about the plans of God coming to fruition according to his plan. Because the devil can delay you, whether we like it or not. The enemy too can delay. But today we're decreeing and declaring, let there be early satisfaction in our lives. And may God show us mercy in Jesus' name. Amen. Prophetic decree number 11. God shall fulfill the number of my days. Somebody say, oh God, fulfill the number of my days. There are people that are wealthy, but they are not fulfilled. There are people that have millions in their accounts, but they are not fulfilled. There are people that have all they wanted to do, but is married. They're married, they're still not fulfilled. Some people, all they wanted was to have children. They have children, but still not fulfilled. Life is such that you can have anything, that everything that you need, but without God, you will never be fulfilled. And so we're decreeing and declaring this morning that may the number of our days be fulfilled in the name of Jesus. May the number of our days be fulfilled in the name of Jesus. You can have a job and still not be fulfilled. You're going to that job, but you're crying because you know inside you that this is not what God wants for you. So we will not live an unfulfilled life, but we will live a fulfilled life in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 12, let me run through quickly. We shall enjoy all year round favor. Somebody decree and declare, I will enjoy all year round favor. Somebody decree and declare, you will enjoy all year round favor in the name of Jesus. Favor from the north, the south, the east, and the west in the name of Jesus. Favor is such that somebody might not like you, but they will still bless you. Favor is such that somebody would hate your guts, but they have no choice but to favor you. That manager doesn't like you, but he has no choice but to promote you. That's what favor is. You don't deserve that job, but you still got it. You don't deserve that man, but he still married you. There were men, women that were more beautiful than you, but he chose you. That is what I call favor. Marriage is not a right, it's a privilege. So when you are married, thank God, it is not a right. You are privileged to be married because favor has found you. You are privileged to marry because favor has located you. And so we're decreeing and declaring the favor of God. When you are favored, you cannot be rejected. When you are favored, you cannot be in a battle for a long time. When you are favored, when people are knocking on doors for 10 years and they are still locked, you're going to knock on that door and within 5 seconds, the door would open. That is the kind of favor we're commanding in our lives this morning, that we shall be favored in the name of Jesus. Wherever we go, the favor of God will locate us. Wherever we are mentioned favor, even in the midst of our enemy's camp, when they gather together to destroy us, the favor of God will speak in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, I shall enjoy all year round favor in Jesus' name. Amen. Prophetic decree number 13, the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. God is saying that whatever you went through last year, it is nowhere compared to the testimonies ahead of you. God is saying that the tears that you shed last year is nowhere compared to the song that you are about to sing this year. God is saying that the test that you went through a few years ago, a year ago, a month ago, is nowhere compared to the testimonies that you are about to release. Hallelujah. God is saying that the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. God is saying that I want you to stop worrying. I want you to stop throwing the towel. I want you to stop saying that God, if you were going to do it, you would do it, because he says he would do it anyway. And so God is saying the glory shall be greater. The testimonies this year shall be greater. The breakthroughs this year shall be greater. Hallelujah. It shall be greater in the name of Jesus. I'm trying to remove this thing that is striking my head. This light that just come. Anyhow, we just continue. The glory shall be greater. Somebody say, my testimonies this year will be greater. My celebration this year will be greater. Somebody think the year has already ended. So God can bless you in the 9th, in the 11th hour. 11th hour. God can decide to give you everything that you've been praying for from January. On the 31st of December, God can decide to give you every prayer, answered prayers, for every prayer that you prayed from January. You say, 31st December, here is every prayer. I've answered it for you. God can show up anytime. And he's saying, the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. In other words, what is ahead of you is sweeter, is bigger, is more glorious than what you went through. Hallelujah. Prophetic decree number 14, I shall not die, but I shall live. Hallelujah. When we talk about death, we're not just talking about spiritual death. We're talking about death in finances, death in relationship, death in your health. Like nothing is working in your life. You are alive, but you are dead, if that makes sense. Physically, you are alive, but spiritually, you are gone. You are working. Yes, there's income coming in. There's money coming. At the end of the month, you can't account for nothing. That will not be our portion in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I will not die, but I shall live. I will not die physically. I will not die spiritually, but I shall live in the name of Jesus. We're all going to die one day. But when we talk about we will not die, but we shall live, we're saying we're not going to die before our time. Hallelujah. So somebody are decreeing and declaring that I shall not die, but I shall live. Anyone that wants to see us dead, they will die and we will go to their funeral. Period. Anyone that is working behind the scenes, they want you to die. They want your marriage to die. They want your finances to die. They want your health to be bad. Whatever they wish for us, it will happen to them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We shall not die, but we shall live. Somebody say, I will not die, but I shall live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Prophetic decree number 15. This year I am swimming in the over and the above blessings of God. Somebody decree and declare you are going to swim in the over and the above blessings of God. That it doesn't matter who has cursed you, every curse will turn into a blessing. We are not walking in the blessings of God. We are not crawling in the blessings of God. We are swimming in the over and the above blessings of God, because we serve a God of overflow. We serve a God of more than enough. He says, Simon, I want you to launch into the deep. You said yesterday you went to look for fish. You didn't have no fish. Jesus said, I want you to launch into the deep, because I am God. I will give you more than enough. The Bible says when they obeyed, they had more than enough. And the net that the fish was in was about to break. Somebody, that is going to be your story in the name of Jesus. All you got to do is obey God. God is saying your abundance is in your obedience. Your blessing is attached to your obedience. If you can obey my word, I will bless you to the point where the blessed will call you blessed. Hallelujah. So we're decreeing and declaring this morning that we are swimming in the over and the above blessings of God in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 16, I will excel in all things. You must excel in that business. Just because the business is not going anywhere today, you must see it going far tomorrow. Hallelujah. You don't conclude on the now. Hallelujah. Because you serve a God that can do the impossible. Even when you are zero right now, your account is red. You gotta prophesy millions into your account. Hallelujah. And the God that giveth money, he says, silver is mine and gold is mine. He will give you an idea that will make you a millionaire. He will give you connections that will bring you wealth. Am I talking to somebody this morning? And so we're decreeing this morning that we will excel in all things, not excel in one and struggle in another, but we will excel in all things in the name of Jesus. You will not have money and be bedridden. You will not be married and be struggling in your marriage because there's no peace and there's no joy. The man is hitting you every day, beating you every day, abusing you every day. The man has not stepped up to be the man in the family. You as a wife have become a breadwinner for years and years and years and years. That would not be your portion in the name of Jesus. We're going to excel in all things in Jesus' name. 17 prophetic decree. This year I will flourish in all areas of my life. Somebody decree and declare, I shall flourish in every area of my life. Somebody decree and declare, I will thrive. Somebody decree and declare, I shall flourish. He said that righteous is like a palm tree. Yeah? the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. It is the promise of God over your life and my life that we shall flourish like a palm tree in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 18. God will settle me this year and grant me my heart desires. Somebody decree and declare. 1 Peter 5:10. You all know this scripture, get me going. That you guys know this scripture is my food. It's my breakfast, my lunch, and my dinner. Anytime I see the scripture, anytime the scripture drops into my spirit, I start dancing instead of crying. Because I'm just thinking, God, you have spoken that this ain't going to last forever. God, you have spoken that I'm not going to be crying forever. God, you've just said to me that I'm not going to be single forever. God, you've just told me that I'm not divorcing. The devil is a liar. The Bible says in 1 Peter 5:10, but the God of all grace, who has called unto us into his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, after your marriage is under attack for a while, after you've been begging for bread for a while, after you've been sick for a while, after you've been single for a while, after you've been going through battles for a while, after that business has been on a standstill for a long time, for a while, God is saying, what will I do? I will perfect you. Anything in your life that needs to be perfected, I, God, would perfect it. I will establish you. I will strengthen you. And then I will settle you. Somebody, let this scripture be in your bedroom. Engraved on your bedroom. You wake up in the morning, you look at this scripture, and you are just like, God, I know you got me. That no matter what I'm going through right now, you are still speaking to me. It is but for a moment. Hallelujah. He said, I will settle you. He says, I will perfect you. I will establish you. I will strengthen you in the name of Jesus. May that be our portion in the name of Jesus. That anyone here that is going through a battle and you're about to lose your mind, God is saying it is going to pass. Anybody here going through a situation where you just want to kill yourself because you are tired of being tired, God is saying that don't give up. It is for a while. You're going through rejection right now. God is saying don't give up. It is for a while. You're going through a situation where you are not settled, you are not established. God is saying it is for a while. You've been single for far too long and you're thinking, God, what is wrong with me? God is saying it is for a while. When I'm ready, I, God, will perfect you. I, God, will establish you. I, God, will strengthen you. And I, God, will settle you in the name of Jesus. Somebody one more time decree and declare. May God settle me and grant me the desires of my heart. Prophetic decree number 19. This year, God will order my steps. The steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. A lot of you have been ordering your steps. That's why you keep falling. A lot of you have been ordering your steps. That's why the traps of the enemy keep trapping you. A lot of you are ordering your steps. That's why you're still in pain. A lot of you are still ordering your steps. That's why you're still struggling. A lot of you are ordering your steps. That's why you're still single. And God is saying, I want to lead you. I want to direct you. Who drives your destiny determines where you're going. Whoever you have allowed to drive your destiny car will determine where you end up. So the question I want to ask somebody today, who is driving your destiny? Who is the one behind the wheel of your destiny car? God is saying, I want to be the driver of that car. I want to drive your destiny. I want to lead. I want to guide. I want to direct you. All I want you to do is follow me. When you follow God, he leads you to your rightful destination. God doesn't make mistakes. That's how I see it. I'm just thinking, he created me. He loves me so much that he doesn't want to see me suffer. So why would I allow somebody else lead me rather than God? And so today we're decreeing that God, please order my steps. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. A shepherd leads a flock. Make sure they're eating. Make sure they're protected. Make sure they're looked after. And that is what God has want. God wants to do. He has brought himself to the level of being a shepherd for you and I. And some of you are still not following. Some of you are still not allowing to order his steps today. Going forward, may God order our steps in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 20. I shall be fruitful and I shall multiply in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, I shall be fruitful and I shall multiply in the name of Jesus. Fruitlessness is not the plan of God for you and I. God wants us to be fruitful. God wants us to multiply. When we talk about fruitfulness, we're not just talking about having children. fruitfulness in everything. Your business will be fruitful. Your marriage will be fruitful. Whatever you lay your hands on shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, I shall be fruitful and I shall multiply. It says in the book of Genesis, be fruitful and multiply. It says, subdue. I want you to rule. I want you to conquer. I want you to take over. Hallelujah. And so we're decreeing one more time that we shall be fruitful and we shall multiply on every side in the name of Jesus. No multiplication in marriage, because you're meant to have one wife, one husband. So if you're here and you marry more than one wife, go and fire one and keep one. Go and dump one and keep one. Fruitfulness has nothing to do with marriage. Somebody said it cheekily the other day. So it ain't got to do with marriage. God said one wife, one husband. Don't go and be marrying more than one woman to bring headache to your life. I shall be fruitful and I shall multiply in the name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 21. God shall deliver me from the evil work of the enemy. Somebody decree and declare this morning, oh God, deliver me from every evil work of the enemy. Somebody decree and declare this morning, oh God, deliver me from every evil work of the enemy. If you know any man that's married more than one wife, tell them to fire one. It is they will know which one to fire. One must go and one must stay. May God deliver us from every evil work of the enemy in the name of Jesus. 2 Timothy 4:18 said, and the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work of the enemy and will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom. We're praying for preservation. May God preserve our lives. May God preserve our lives. May God save us. May God protect us in the mighty name of Jesus. Prophetic decree number 22. Deuteronomy 28:6, wherever I go, whatever I do, I shall be blessed. This is like an anthem, like God, I will not suffer. I am allergic to suffering, allergic to poverty, allergic to lack, allergic to losing. I cannot lose. How can I serve a winning God and be losing? How can I serve a God that wins, a God that conquers, and I'm still losing? It is not possible. It says in Deuteronomy 28:6, wherever you go, whatever you do, you shall be blessed. Your going out is blessed. Your coming in is blessed. It is blessing all around, blessing all over. And so you're decreeing today in the name of Jesus that you are blessed in the north, south, east, and west. You're going out and your coming in is blessed. It doesn't matter where you're going, blessings will follow you. It doesn't matter where you're coming from, the blessings of the Lord shall follow you in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, you are blessed 7 times in Jesus' name. I am blessed. I am blessed. Blessings galore. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed in the name of Jesus. And so shall it be. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So shall it be in the matchless name of Jesus. Blessed everywhere. It doesn't matter what's going on right now, you are blessed. It doesn't matter what you're confronted right now, you are blessed. It doesn't matter what is in your account right now, you are blessed. You gotta speak it until you see it. Amen. You got to speak it until you see it. It might not look it, but you see it. Hallelujah. It looks like marriage is out of the way, but you're seeing marriage. You're seeing yourself walking down that aisle. No matter how difficult the situation is, can you believe it? If you can believe it, it shall surely come to pass. The reason why some of you are not seeing the manifestations of your prayers is because you lack faith. You doubt so much. You are praying, but your mind is saying, is this going to happen? How can God work with people like that? God don't work with doubtful people. God works with people that are audacious in faith. Like you have an audacious faith where it is like you're praying and you don't car this one. In the eyes of men, it's not possible, but your faith said it is possible. Some of you must get out of the doubting. God don't deal with doubt people. Doubting Thomases can't deal with, cannot work with God. God do not deal with doubtful vessels. God deals with people that believe and have faith. That even though the mountain is right before you, you know that that mountain is about to be made plain. That whatever your enemies confront you with, you know and you know and you know that whatever it is shall leave you in the name of Jesus. Am I ministering to someone? Stop doubting and start believing. Somebody say, Father, in the name of Jesus, let every doubt in me be casted out in the name of Jesus. Some of you, The witch in your family, yeah? The witch in your life is the spirit of doubt. There is no witch anywhere. There is no wizard anywhere. The witch is inside you. It is called the spirit of doubt. You doubt too much. I can be here prophesying to you. What is he talking about? This is my 20 year. What are you talking about, Pastor C? Please, doubting Thomases. I can say, go and get that job. You are doubting. When I told Halia Carvalho, I see good news coming your way, whatever it is that I prophesied into her life. It was only a matter of time. It manifested. Why? Because he took the word. He believed in the word. He believed in the prophecy and stood on it, and it manifested. Some of you, the reason why there's no answer to the prophetic that's released to you, you don't believe. You are not taking it. You see, prophecy is like, I'm just a postman, a postwoman. Let's see it that way. Somebody works for Royal Mail. I'm working for God. And I release what he wants me to release. It's up to you to take it or to throw it away. So if there's a delivery that's been sent to your house, let's say I sent a pair of shoes to Harriet Jammy. I said, well, Harriet, you know, I know your size. I know you like this shoe. I bought it for you. I've delivered it to you. Harriet knows that the delivery is going to come on a Saturday. And she refused to open that door and take the delivery. She refused to open that door and answer to the postman. Will the delivery man stand there and wait for him? No. It is only a matter of time. He's gone. So some of you, the delivery has been released, but you are not receiving it because you are doubting, because your mind is full of questions. You ask so many questions that you don't receive. And yet you say, well, this man of God is not genuine. How is she not genuine? How is he not genuine? If other people are seeing miracles, if other people are testifying, if other people's prophecies are coming to pass, why is your one not coming to pass? That's the question you must ask yourself. That is the question you must ask yourself. Some of you, your packages have been released years ago, but you refuse to open the door and take your parcel. And so the parcel was returned. And it will only take the grace of God for that parcel to be resent to you again. You see how they drop a Royal Mail card for you and say, you gotta go and pick it up yourself. Some of you, that Royal Mail card has expired in the spiritual realm because you didn't go to pick it up in prayer. Doubt is a killer. Doubt is a killer. It is of the devil. So anytime you realize that you doubt so much, you gotta stop praying and deal with that spirit of doubt, because no prayer would be answered by people that doubt too much. Some of you have been praying for you saying, it's like, as I see, stop praying because this ain't gonna work. Can you just receive it? Can you just receive the word and believe it and it shall work for you? Harriet Jammy tuned in on TV on Saturday and called the TV line and said, my blood pressure has gone up. And we prayed for her. And we said to her, before this live broadcast ends, your blood pressure is going to come down. And true. Before we stepped out of the TV studio, she sent us a screenshot of her temperature, of her blood pressure, how it was before we prayed, and how it was after we have prayed. The blood pressure came down. So when a word is released, you gotta catch the word. If you don't catch it, somebody will catch it for you. That's why some people say, well, Pastor C, you were prophesying to somebody and I tapped into the prophecy and it worked for me. You know what that means? If you're sitting there and I'm prophesying that you will marry, and your mind said, marry, where's the man? Somebody that has the faith will tap into that prophecy and they will marry. You that had the prophecy, you that prophecy was released to, you'll be sitting there single. But somebody that the prophecy wasn't meant for caught a revelation that this might not be me, but a prophecy for one is a prophecy for all. I am tapping into this prophecy. And before you know it, it has manifested in their lives. And the one that the prophecy was meant for is still single, looking for marriage. So there are spiritual principles. God doesn't deal with doubtful people. When you doubt, you stop God from working, because you're telling him that, God, you are not capable of what you say you can do. I'm spending time telling somebody this because you'll be here on this TYM and you will never testify because you have not connected, number one. Number two, your mind is full of doubts. God bless you, my husband, Prophet Power. So today we're praying. Our first prayer point today, we're going to kill that demon of doubt. We're going to kill the spirit of doubt that is stopping you from testifying, stopping you from breaking through, stopping you from getting answers to your prayers. That spirit of doubt must leave you today. Somebody say, Father, in the name of Jesus, any spirit of doubt in me, I cast you out in the name of Jesus. Any spirit of doubt fighting my testimony, any spirit of doubt fighting my breakthrough, any spirit of doubt fighting my deliverance, I command you out of my life in the name of Jesus. I command you out of my life in the name of Jesus. Doubt is a source, it's from the devil. It ain't got nothing to do with God, but everything to do with the devil. So anytime you see yourself doubting, know that the devil is fighting you. The enemy has captured your mind to the point where it doesn't matter who has prophesied. It doesn't matter who's laid their hands on you. You don't believe, and because you don't believe, you will not get. Jesus said, if only you will believe, if only you will believe, I will do the impossible in your life. So today we decree and declare, everything that causes us to doubt God, doubt the word of God, doubt what God is capable of doing in our lives, may it give way in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So by 11, I'm going. So we're going to pray some two prayers before I prophesy into people's lives. I think there are some testimonies that needs to be shared. Harriet Jami has a testimony. Suntu has a testimony, but I haven't seen Suntu, so maybe she's at work. But I'll allow Harriet Jami to testify. I'll allow her to testify. Every doubt in me, cast out. Be casted out and send your prayer request. Oh God, there's a lot to do. I will take prayer requests as well, so we're just gonna pray some few prayers. Hallelujah. You must say to yourself, I must testify, whether the devil likes it or not, I will testify. Doubt will destroy you. Hallelujah. We're going to pray Ephesians 4:27. It's still in line with, you know, this spirit of doubt. It is from the devil. We're praying Ephesians 4:27 says, and give no opportunity to the devil. Some of you give opportunity to the devil. Some of you give opportunity to the devil and not to God though. When you doubt, you are giving opportunity to the devil to manipulate your mind. Give no opportunity to the devil. And so today we're going to pray this prayer. Father, any opportunity that I've given to the devil and is fighting me right now, may you have mercy in the name of Jesus. Today we're decreeing and declaring that, Father, any opportunity I have given to the devil and is fighting me, oh God, may you have mercy in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare, any opportunity I have given to the devil and is fighting me right now, Father, deliver me. Father, have mercy in the name of Jesus. Somebody decree and declare this morning, any opportunity I have given to the devil, oh God, and is fighting my destiny, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy in the name of Jesus. Whatever opportunity I have given to the devil and is fighting me, I can't break through. I can't testify. Father, Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, forgive me today, this morning, for any opportunity I have given to the devil. And from today going forward, may I never give the devil an opportunity to destroy me. May I never give the devil an opportunity to break my home. May I never give the devil an opportunity to afflict me. Ha! May I never give the devil the opportunity to send me to the grave in the name of Jesus. May it never happen in the mighty name of Jesus. And any time and any day, any way, any form, any shape that we have given the devil an opportunity to fight us, may God have mercy on us in the name of Jesus. And every door that I have opened for the devil to come in, Father, close that door for me, please. There are doors that we have opened and the devil has entered. I won't even start telling you how that happened, but I'll break it down one day, because I said to myself, once a month I will preach on this live broadcast to be a blessing to somebody. So whatever door we have opened for the devil and he has entered and is fighting us, may God close that door in the mighty name of Jesus. Madabadebe. Second Samuel 22, verse 15. We have two more scriptures and then I'll pray. I'll use the prayer points, pray for people, and then prophesy. It's Margaret here. Second Samuel 22, 15 said, he sent out arrows. God does send out arrows. He sent out arrows and scattered them. God himself sent out arrows and scattered them. Today we're decreeing and declaring, may God release arrows into the camp of our enemies. Father, in the name of Jesus, release arrows into the camp of my enemies, oh God. Somebody decree and declare, oh God, according to your word in 2 Samuel 22:15, may you release arrows into the camp of my enemies and scatter them by fire in the name of Jesus. Some of you, if your enemies are not scattered, they will scatter you. You are too gentle and you fold your hands and say, I don't trouble anybody, so nobody will trouble you. Because you don't trouble anybody, somebody will trouble you. You don't have to be evil for people to fight you. If that was the case, a lot of people would not fight fights in this life, because some people are genuinely good, but they are still fought. So today we're decreeing and declaring, God does release arrows, and we're decreeing and declaring in the name of Jesus, may God release arrows into the camp of our enemies and scatter them by fire in the name of Jesus. Enemies of progress, enemies that don't want to see you smile, enemies that want to see you broken, enemies that want to see you cry every day, enemies that don't want to see you marry, enemies that don't want to see you have children, enemies that don't want to see you have your papers in the country that you're in, enemies of progress, enemies of joy, enemies of peace. Today, may God send arrows into the camp of our enemies and scatter them in the mighty name of Jesus. If you don't have an enemy, pray for me. Yeah? Because some of you don't have enemies. Good luck. Some of us, we do. So if you don't have enemies, don't ignore this prayer. Pray for Prophetess C, okay? God, send arrows into the camp of my enemies and scatter them in the name of Jesus. May the evil plans never work in Jesus' name. Scatter them in the name of Jesus. Enter their camp, oh God, with your arrows. Let your arrows invade the camp of my enemies and scatter them. Somebody open your mouth and pray. Somebody is the reason why you're suffering right now. Somebody is the reason why your business is not flourishing. Somebody is the reason why you are not married right now. Somebody is responsible somewhere. They will be scattered in the name of Jesus. May God release arrows into their camps and scatter them in the mighty name of Jesus. If you don't pray, you'll be a prey to the devil. You're going to be radical in the things of God and understand that the warfares that we're in, they are not physical. They are spiritual. And you cannot win a spiritual battle physically. You're going to rise up and start decreeing and declaring. Start throwing lightning and thunder into the camp of your enemies. Start throwing arrows into their camp, that they will not rest, neither have peace, until they let you go. Hallelujah. Our last scripture, Psalm 21, verse 11. Psalm chapter 21, the verse of 11. It said, he sent out arrows. No, sorry. Though they plan evil against you, though they devise mischief, they will never succeed. God is saying that even though they have planned evil against you, even though they have went to that juju man, the demonic and satanic altars to fight you, even though they have released curses against you, even though they have given you food to eat to poison you, it will never succeed. Some of you, you love food. You eat everywhere. You drink everywhere. You just eat. And God is saying, whatever you have eaten that was poisonous and you thought it was food, it will never succeed in the name of Jesus. That every evil plot of the enemy will never stand in the name of Jesus. That whatever they've done against us, whether it's a curse, whether it's by them laying hands on us,
whether it's by them hugging us, whatever it is, whatever, however they have deposited evil in our lives, today we're decreeing and declaring they will never succeed in the name of Jesus. We're decreeing and declaring by the power in the mighty name of Jesus, according to the word of God in Psalm 21, the verse of 11, though they will plan evil, though they will plan mischief, we're decreeing and declaring it shall never work in the name of Jesus. They will never succeed in the mighty name of Jesus. We're decreeing and declaring that anyone that's ganged up together, any group of people that have come up together to destroy us, anyone that has vowed, I will not marry, I will divorce, I'll be sicker, I will not enjoy life, we're decreeing and declaring, may their decrees never come to pass. We're decreeing and declaring that whatever they have done will not succeed in the name of Jesus. Whatever evil that they've done, may God turn it around for our good in the mighty name of Jesus. We're decreeing and declaring that those that want to see us cry, they will see us laughing in the name of Jesus. We're decreeing and declaring those that don't want to see us married, they will see us married, happily married, successfully married in the name of Jesus. The opposite shall occur in Jesus' name. When they want to see you fall, the opposite will occur. When they want to see you cry, the opposite will occur. When they want to see you divorce, the opposite will occur. Whatever they want to see me into, the opposite shall occur. May fire visit the camp of our enemies. May the consuming fire of God be set ablaze into the camp of our enemies in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There is evil in this world. People are wicked. The Bible said the heart of man is desperately wicked. So I'm about to enter into prayers, pray for prayer requests before I prophesy to a few people. But before I do that, can you share the video? And then I'll invite testimonies. Some of you people, I don't know what I've done for you. When I say share, you don't share. Somebody share the video. Somebody share the video. Somebody share the video. Somebody share the video. Just share. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, you shall be the next in line to testify. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, wherever your destiny husband is, he shall locate you in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, you will see no bad news, you will hear no bad news in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, may good news knock on your door right now in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, anything in your body that is not of God is flushed out by the blood in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, you will not hear no bad news this year. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, may your enemies be put to shame in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, may everything that you've been waiting on God for come to fruition in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare as you're sharing, may there be a promotion in your house, in your household, in the name of Jesus. As you're sharing, you will see no sorrow in Jesus' name. As you're sharing, may God make your enemies your footstool in the mighty name of Jesus. May the blessing of evangelism come upon you like never before in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for sharing, everybody. Some will still not share. I pray for you, Ellen Cabras. Is Ellen watching here? Somebody send a prayer request called Ellen from Tabokoto. Tabokoto. Is Ellen from Tabokoto here? I want to pray for her. Are you here, please? Shandele babo satale, but the devil is a liar. Ellen, are you here? Thank you for sharing. Thank you for sharing. Is she here, Eliza? I want to pray for her. Is she here?
If she comes and let me know, I'll pray for her. I only pray for people that are around. Good morning. Thank you for sharing, Jamal. Good morning, Deacon Jamal. I'm doing well. Miss you a lot, girl. You have been bad. Thank you, Harriet. Good morning, Prophetess C. May God continue filling your portion of favor and wisdom for the amazing work you do. Thank you. Please pray for my sweet favors, sweet corns business. I was approached by a gentleman from Ghana who would like to sell my favors in his country. However, I want to hear from the Lord to guide me with prayers on how we can venture into Ghana. I pray for you today as God has brought you a destiny helper. May God give you wisdom and may God give you the grace on how to go about this in the mighty name of Jesus. That it will not be a loss, but it shall be a gain. In Jesus' name, amen. Good morning, Prophetess. My prayer request is for God to give me and my family peace and settle every issue going on. I pray for your family this morning. I command peace in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare, let there be peace in the mighty name of Jesus. Lena Mendy, I need to pray for you. Let there be peace in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be peace in your family in the name of Jesus. Anything that causes chaos in your home, today I decree and I declare the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. May that peace be in your family in the name of Jesus. Last night, though. So Harriet James' blood pressure has me. I don't know how to read blood pressure. If you send me 125 over 79, is that normal? Me, I'm not very medical, unfortunately. 125 over 79 is good, eh? Because when we prayed for you, it was 160 something, right? Over whatever. Yesterday night, it was 125 over 79. Is that good or is bad? It cannot be bad. My bishopess, what is it? Good morning, Prophetess C. Thank you for the prayers, concern, and standing by my son. God has answered your prayers and favors me with a job he's been looking for. My son got 4 different interviews for this only one job. 2 weeks ago, they phoned him that he wasn't qualified. After 2 weeks again, they ring him and offered him the job and said because of his personality, he calm, nice, and gentle. Only God can do that. He was highly favored. Thank you so much. I remember, you know, this lady sent a prayer request on the 27th of June. This is another testimony. He sent his prayer request. Oh, that's very good. We give God the glory. It cannot be bad. He said, good morning, Prophetess Sisi. 27th of June. Please remember my son. He has interviewed twice. Last week was the second, so that God will favor him, grant him the good, God grant him the job. Thanks. Have a good, nice day. 27th of June. Today, there is a testimony. What's today's date? Because this thing keeps failing me. 8th of August. A job came. He has gotten the job. So please, baby Nuku, can you write this testimony properly and send it to me? Because I want to share it. Can you write the testimony properly and send it to me, please? Let me just save your name because I didn't save your name before. Can you just write the testimony well and send it to me, please? So I can share it because I love sharing testimonies. I'll just make sure your name is not in the testimony because there's just too much evil. So, can you just write the testimony again and send it to me? Amen. Thank you, Louis Sambo. Amen. I received the prayer. That was a powerful testimony. 27 June, prayed for a job. Today, he's got the job. Hallelujah. Good morning, Prophetess. Pray for me for divine healing. I'm sick. Yesterday, Mary Ann. Mary Ann, are you here? I want to pray for you. There is going to be instant healing in the name of Jesus. Is Mary Ann here? Is Mary Ann on this live broadcast? If you're here, powerful testimony. God bless you, Pastor Esther. Powerful testimonies. God never stops blowing my mind. Mary Ann, if you're here, let me know, then I'll pray for you. Hello. I have been staying connected on CYM. I need this one favor from the Lord for me to pass my social policy module and the Lord to work in my favor for me to progress into second year. But once again, thank you with commanding your morning. This has helped me to get closer to God. That alone is a testimony.
that alone is a testimony for somebody to say, commanding your money has helped me get closer to God. That's the highest testimony ever. That is the biggest testimony ever for somebody to say, you know, I was never close to God, but commanding your morning has gotten me closer to God. I never used to pray, but because of commanding your morning, I pray now. I remember Marikumba said to me in my office, Pastor C, I decree and I declare. And this is something that I never used to do. But I decree and I declare, I pray and I stand on scriptures and I actually use the scriptures and I pray. For me, that is the greatest joy I can, that's the sweetest song I can ever want to hear. Just to see people get closer to God, to see people now get used to the habit of praying, because so long as you are praying, things will happen. Hallelujah. So this alone is a testimony. That thank you. Somebody I don't know, just been following me. My sister said to me the other day that I was in a hospital. Mariba said to me, I was in a hospital and my boss, who is a Muslim, said to me, you know, I watch your sister. And my sister was like, oh, okay. The woman is a Muslim. The woman is her boss. And the woman said, I watch your sister every morning. This is a Muslim woman that doesn't follow Jesus Christ. But somehow, she watches my life, because so my sister was like, you don't even know who watches you. You just go there. I said, I ain't got no clue. I have no clue. I said, a lot of people tell me that I watch your sister online. She's been a blessing to my life. She's been this. She's been that. I'm just thinking, glory to God. This is what it is all about. Just touching lives and being a blessing to people. So, you know, that is why we do what we do, to get people closer to God and just take people out of darkness into light. So just to hear this is like, thank you, Jesus. That commanding your morning has helped me to get closer to God. I pray for you today. You didn't send me your name, but the rule is I need your name. I like addressing people by their name. It is not for prophecy, because I'm not coming and saying, your name is Aret, you live in Gambia. That's not my line of prophecy. Hallelujah. So when I ask for your name, it's literally to address you by name. Amen. So I pray for you today. May God grant you favor. And may you fly with flying colors. May you pass with flying colors in your social policy module. I decree and I declare God will give you wisdom to excel. God will give you wisdom to come out with flying colors. May God favor you in the name of Jesus. And may you come back with a testimony in Jesus' name. Amen. She's going to come back. My name is Dorcas. Hi, Dorcas. I think you're the one that's watching from Zambia. No, this is UK, I think. Well, Dorcas, you will come back and testify. I decree and I declare this morning over your life, you will pass that module. God will grant you favor in Jesus' name. And God will give you a new song in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. You're going to come back and testify in the mighty name of Jesus. Today is the 8th of August. You will come back and testify in Jesus' name. Amen. Dorcas Liziki. What a nice name. Let's go. I've saved your number, by the way. Louis Touré. Louis Touré, you have not testified. Louis Touré, you have not testified. Louis Touré, is that the Louis Touré? The beautiful lady that's in Gambia. That's you, in it. That's you. Louis Touré, you have not testified. I need your testimonies, Louis Touré. Good morning, prophetess. God bless you. I just want to thank you for my life and all he is doing for me and my business. I'm on a way better place. Business is going smooth. Opportunities are locating me, and I give thanks. What a testimony. What a testimony. I remember some time ago, this lady, you know, said, oh no, she actually sent a testimony. I did not see this one. It's a testimony time. Remember, you prayed for my financial elevation in my life and business. I prayed for financial elevation and I prayed for a business, because she sent a prayer request regarding her financial situation and her business. And he said, remember, I like to be remembered. Remember, you prayed for my financial elevation in life and my business. It has been number one of my prayer points since I started CYM. Jesus, I received money, yo. Pastor C, money. And this will not only save my business, but me too. It came just in time. I have to pay for my store rent. Also, sales have been down too. But believe me when I tell you, I'm getting orders online and sales in store. I give thanks to God in the name of Jesus. Financial elevation and sales in her business. That is why I say, those of you that are into business, don't give up on your business. God is still working behind the scenes. All you gotta do is keep believing, keep praying, and listen, let me tell you something. There is something called a season of manifestation. There is a season of manifestation where you will manifest and it will shock you. All you gotta do is wait on God. Literally, wait on God, because He's a God that does, overdoes, and extra does. Am I saying something? Am I speaking correct English right now? The God we serve, He can do, overdo, extra do in the name of Jesus. So we thank God for the life of Louis Toure, and I pray that, you know, may you continue to testify in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Good morning, Prophetess Cici. August is my birth month, and I want a Belgian student visa as my birthday present. May God grant it to you in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare, as you need a Belgian passport, may God give it to you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that your helpers will locate you and assist you in completing your building project in the mighty name of Jesus. Any destiny helper that God has in store for you to help you finish your building project, may God bring them your way in the name of Jesus. I pray for supernatural intelligence to enable you to do extremely well in your studies in Belgium, starting from September 2022, in Jesus' name, amen. Good morning, Pastor C. Praying for unity, forgiveness, understanding, and peace in my family. My name is Mary Ann. Mary Ann, I pray for you today. May there be unity in your family. No, they didn't send a new iPhone, no. Harriet Carvalho. God bless you for seeing well. The new iPhone has not arrived. Harriet Carvalho, the new iPhone has not arrived. This phone, I get trouble because me, I'm not an Android person. I am not good with Android at all. Android is not my thing. So they have not sent my iPhone. Thank you very much for speaking for me. Mary Ann, I pray for you. I pray for you. I pray for unity in your family. I pray for forgiveness, I pray for understanding, and I pray for peace in your family in the name of Jesus. It shall be done in Jesus' name, amen. Hello, here is my testimony. Somebody say another testimony. If you have not testified on this platform, can you cry out to God? Because it's your time to testify. It will be an error for you not to testify up till today. It is impossible. You have to start testifying. Hello, Eugenia. This is Eugenia. Says, hello, Pastor. Here is my testimony. I have been praying for my girls, Scarlett and Courtney, and finally got a response for Courtney. Just wait for her passport to come back. Praying it comes with good news that she has the visa to join me in the UK. Let me tell you something. Your sisters are coming to join you in the UK. Husband, if you're watching me, please come. God, I'm crying for a testimony. You gotta cry for that testimony. You gotta say to yourself, I am next in line to testify. This lady was sending prayer requests for her children. And she now said, finally, I got a response for my daughter, Courtney. And I decree and I declare, it shall not only be a response, but it shall be a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So where is Lena? Something Lena. There's a Lena that I want to pray for. I'm next in line to testify. In the name of Jesus. I think, where is Lena? I mentioned Lena and I mentioned Margaret. I want to speak to these two people. I want to speak to their lives. Good morning, prophetess. I hope you are well. My prayer request is that God will show me favor for a new job this month. I've been applying and I'm waiting to hear back from a few interviews. May God bless you. Natalie, I pray for you today. May God give you the best job ever in the name of Jesus. If for anything, if for nothing, let your service to God usher you into the best. May God surprise you in the name of Jesus. That's all I'm saying. May God surprise you in the area of your job. In Jesus' name, amen. You will testify in the mighty name of Jesus. Where is Marilena? Lena, is Lena here? Okay, Lena is not here. Where is Margaret? Where is Margaret? Margaret Cavallo, where are you? Where is Margaret? Lena and Margaret are both here. Okay, where is Lena? Is Lena there? Lena. Lena, are you here? Yes, I'm here. Okay, this is what I'm seeing. I don't know if you're married. I don't know you from anywhere. Lena, Mendy, you are a manjango like me, but I don't know you from nowhere. But this is what I'm seeing. I don't know if you're married, but I'll be surprised if you're married. I saw like a black ring on your finger. As I'm talking to you right now, there's a black ring on your finger spiritually. Yeah, so you're probably looking, but you won't see. There is a black ring on your finger. You have been married spiritually. I don't know if this has ever happened to you, where you see yourself sleeping with people in the dream. Now, don't be embarrassed about this, because it happened to a lady before, a grown woman that says to me, anytime I sleep, I see myself sleeping with men in my dream. And I said to him, that is demonic. Literally, that is demonic. And I said to her, don't worry, I will send you prayer points and scriptures. And I did, and I sent her prayer points and scriptures. Within 1 week, she said to me, Pastor C, from the time I started praying the scriptures and the prayer points you sent me, I have not had that dream ever again. Now, some things you don't have to be embarrassed about, because you need to be delivered. Lena Mendy, I don't know if you are married, but I'd be surprised if you are married. But I see a black ring. You are spiritually married. And if that ring is not taken out of your finger, marriage will be a problem. Even if you marry, you will not be happy. You end up divorcing. Why did you say yes? Are you married, Lena Mendy? I'm going to pray for you today. That ring must leave your hand. That ring must leave your hand. You are married. You are married. There is something going on in your marriage, and I want to pray for you. And I want to pray for you, because there is a black ring in your wedding finger. If you have your wedding ring on, there is a black ring on it. And if you are not careful, even though you are married and you have dreams, you will have dreams seeing yourself sleeping with people that is not your husband. Now, this is not to embarrass you, because I want to pray for you, because if care is not taken, your marriage is under attack. Your marriage is under attack. And I want to make sure that ring is out of your finger. Physically married, spiritually married. And so it is such that even though you are married, but the joy that you are meant to get in your marriage is not there. Am I talking to you today? Am I making sense to you today? Am I making sense? Is Lena there? Spirit, physically you are married, okay. People know that you are married. Spiritually you are also married. So even though there's a man next to you that you're married to physically, there's another man spiritually that you're married. And if care is not taken, this marriage, there will be problems. I don't know what is happening in your home right now. Now, this I could have said behind the scenes, but I have to say it now, because there's something that is after your marriage. And if prayer is not prayed, there will be problems in your marriage. Shatale brado shikete. Mashikala bade berekete. I want to pray for you, Lena Mendy. How long have you been married, please? Because what I'm seeing is not good. How long have you been married, please? Kabasikele babos. How long have you been married, please? The problem is not your husband, but there's something going on behind the scenes that wants this marriage to end. They want the marriage to end. How long have you been married, please? 5 years. You've been married for 5 years. They want the marriage to end. And if you can be honest with me, there have been some shaky grounds in the marriage. I just want you to be honest with me, because what I'm seeing, and I will say, it's been very shaky. Yeah, 1 minute, okay, next minute there's a problem. She said, yes, it is true. Now, it only takes the grace of God for me to speak like this, because it is a matter of urgency. If prayer is not prayed, Lena, you'll be frustrated in that marriage and you will walk out. But I pray for you today.
put your hand on your marital finger. Yeah, don't remove your. Are you wearing your wedding ring? Are you wearing your wedding ring? The devil is a lie. You will not divorce. You will not divorce in Jesus' name. You will not divorce. Are you wearing your wedding band? You will not divorce in the name of Jesus. Are you wearing your wedding band? She's not wearing her wedding band. Did you guys hear that? She is not wearing her wedding band. How can you wear your wedding band when there's a black one on your wedding ring? She's not wearing her wedding band. God said, ask her if she's wearing her wedding band before even you pray. She's not wearing her wedding band. Where is your wedding band? Lena, today you'll be set free. That's why I said to you last week, something is not right. I need to deliver you from something. Something is not right. Where is your wedding ring? Kabo Sikele, where is your wedding ring, my dear Lena Mendy? Where is your wedding ring? God is telling me to tell you the battle is over. I just want you to believe it, that the battle is over. Trust me. I don't know you. For me to, I don't see anything. I didn't see anything. Where is your wedding ring? Where is your wedding ring? Where is your wedding band? Lena, where is your wedding? It's lost. So you've never bought one? Your husband hasn't gotten you another one? They want your marriage to end. Are you still with your husband? Are you still in the same house with your husband? Guys, bear with me. I'm dealing with a situation right now. I want to restore somebody's marriage. It is not the will of God for divorce to happen. It is not the will of God. The devil is a liar. Are you with your husband? Are you and your husband, are you in the same house? Today, you are not. The no is, you are married, but you and your husband are not together. Is that what you're saying? This business, so don't carry somebody's prophecy. You are married for 5 years, but you and your husband are not together, right? I know the network is slow, so I'll be patient. With your case, I'll be very patient. If I have to wait for 10 minutes for you to respond, I will wait, because I want to deal with this issue. I want to know something. So you and your husband are not in the, you are not living together. Is that what she's saying? Somebody help me. Is that what she's saying? Her and the husband are not living together, but they're still married. Is that what the issue is here? Okay, I get what you're saying. We are together, but right now I'm at my family. So there is a problem. Did you guys, I made it clear. When she said I'm married, somebody could have said, whoa, I messed up. Mm-mm. Well, I saw what I saw, and God said, speaking. Let me tell you something. There's a black ring on your finger. Lena, go and get water. I'm going to pray for the water, okay? Make sure it's a full cup of water, yeah? And I'm going to pray for you. My mother is sick. Come to help. So you went to help your mom, and your husband is at home. Fine. Go and get a glass of water. Fill the glass with water. Fill the glass with water. I'm going to pray. And I'll ask you to put the finger in the water. And you're not going to remove that finger. You're not going to remove your finger from the water until I end my live broadcast. Can you do that? Can you do that? Because that ring on your finger has been there for a long time. Because you, even this marriage that you're in was a problem. Even this marriage that you're in, there were issues before you married. And so they vowed that you will not have peace in your own marriage. So I'm not surprised you lost your wedding ring. You are not wearing your wedding ring. 5 years of marriage. The devil is a liar. Lena, let me tell you something. Don't give up on your marriage. Okay? God will bring peace back, will bring joy back, and will bring happiness back. Get me a glass of water. Fill it to the brim. And let me pray over the water. And you're going to put this finger of yours in the water. You know what that means? I am removing every spiritual marriage. Whoever married you spiritually, huh? Today they are divorcing you for you to enjoy your physical marriage in the name of Jesus. You got the water. Father, in the name of Jesus, you reveal to redeem, oh God. Father, as she lifts that water, I turn the water into the blood of Jesus.
the blood that speaketh better than the blood of Abel. And I decree and I declare, oh God, as she puts her wedding finger in that water, every marital ring that is locked up in her wedding hand, today I command that ring to come out in the mighty name of God. Anybody that has married you spiritually and they have vowed that you will not enjoy your marriage, today I command that ring to come out of your finger in the name of Jesus. I command that ring to come out of your finger in the name of Jesus. Any plan of the enemy to cause divorce in your home, I cancel it in Jesus' name. Put your hand in the water and you will not remove it until I finish my live broadcast. And when I finish, somebody remind me, because I need to tell Lena what to do before I go. If I be a woman of God, every headache, every battle that is going on in your marriage right now, it is settled in Jesus' name. You go back, hear me clearly. You go back, get a ring, put it back in your finger. Get a ring, put your wedding ring back. Even if it's a $20 ring, it doesn't matter. Let your husband just get you any ring for now. And let your husband put your ring. Let him put the ring back into your finger. Lena, can that be done? Can that be done, Lena? Make sure when you go back to your marital home, or before you go back, tell your husband the prophecy and tell him to buy you a ring. It doesn't have to be an expensive ring. Let it be an affordable ring for now. And let your husband take his hand and put the ring back into your marital finger. Can that be done, Lena? Any problem with your womb, I cancel it. Any problem with your stomach, Any problem with your stomach, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. Any problem with your stomach, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. Your mother will not die before her time. Your mother would not die before her time. I pray for her today. Any sickness that she's confronted with, today may the healing balm of Gilead heal your mom in Jesus' name. Amen. Where is Margaret Carvalho, please? I'm going to go. 5 years, Lena Mendy. How many children do you have, Lena? Margaret Carvalho. I'm going to go. If I have 11, I'm going. So if I don't prophesy to you and I promise you a prophecy, I will give it to you tomorrow. There is a testimony. Kaba yaba yaba yaba. Margaret, where are you? Kaba yaba debe, where is Margaret Carvalho? Somebody said, Margaret, no child. That's why I say, I pray for your womb. I pray for your womb. Every complication in your womb. You need prayers. So, Lena Mendy, you need prayers. There's a battle. There's a battle that you're into. Put your hand on your stomach. That was my last prayer. Any issue in your womb, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. Put your hand in your womb. Put your hand in your stomach. Put your hand in your stomach. Father, I pray for your daughter. Anyone that has vowed that she will never have children, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare by the power in the name of Jesus, let there be a visitation in Jesus' name. Let the battle against her marriage be over in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the battle against her marriage be over in the mighty name of Jesus. You want prayer points? Send me a message. I will send you some scriptures and prayer points. It is well, Lena, okay? Be strong. God will give you a new song to sing. God will give you a new song to sing. In the name of Jesus. But try not to argue too much with your husband, okay? Try not to argue too much with your husband. No matter how difficult it is, try not to argue too much. Can you hear me? Try not to argue too much. Send me a text message. We will continue from there.
I'm not going to go deep into that because it's got to do with your husband, so I'm not going to go there. That's between me and you on the other side. But try to avoid arguments. Try to avoid arguments as much as you can. Try to run away from arguments, okay?
Margaret, I hear God said, I saw you dancing and screaming. I said, ah, God, why is this woman jumping and dancing like this?
God said, I should tell you, there is a good news coming your way, number one. There is restoration coming your way, number two. And there's healing coming your way, number three. Margaret Carvalho, I hear these three things God is telling me. There is a song, there's a testimony you are about to sing. You are about to rejoice, number one. There is a divine restoration coming your way. And number three, there's healing coming your way. I don't know why God is saying healing, but it's like there's an arrow that's sent to you, and the arrow is to inflict you with a sickness. Because you're saying to yourself, I am tired. And God said, I should tell you, that word should not come out of your mouth. I am tired. Because the enemy will use the same word to fight you. God is telling me to tell you, don't get to the point of giving up. It's Margaret Carvalho in this live broadcast. God is telling me to tell you, never get to the point of giving up where you will say with your mouth, I'm tired. May that word never come out of your mouth. If you've ever uttered those words in your life, I want you to swallow them. Never say you are tired. God is saying, I should tell you, he's heard your prayers. He has seen your tears, and he's about to cause you to smile. He's about to cause you to rejoice. He's about to cause you to celebrate. That whatever the enemy meant for evil against your marriage, God is saying, I'm turning it around for your good. She said, very true. Never ever say you are tired. Okay? You are a great woman. And whatever you're going through has nothing to do with you. It's just evil eyes. And there's a covenant in your family. These are covenants that were there before even you were born, that literally fights marriages. But because you have been praying, God said, I should tell you, you have not just prayed for yourself, but you've prayed for the rest of your family. That whatever was done against women in the family, God is saying, I'm using you to break it. I'm using you to break it, whether you like it or not. You are a prayer warrior, Margaret Carvalho. If nobody has ever told you this, I'm telling you this today. You are a prayer warrior. You are a prayer warrior. And God is saying, never stop praying. Never ever shut your mouth. Even when you don't feel like praying, God said, praise me. Praise me. Because God said, your heart is clean. Your heart is in the right place. And I've seen everything that you're going through, and it is time for me to honor you. God doesn't lie. Whatever it is that you're going through, I'm not with you for me to hear you say, I am tired. But God is saying, no, I am about to restore you. I'm about to cause you to sing a new song, and I'm about to heal you. That whatever the enemy has planned against your health, whatever the enemy is cooking against your health, I decree and I declare it will not stand in the name of Jesus. And I pray that there shall be peace in your home. There will be undeniable love in your home. There will be joy restored back to your home in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not wish people well and be going through hardship. It is not correct and it will not happen. But the Lord is telling me to tell you, remember these three things and take it to God in prayer. The Father, as you have used your servant to release these words to me, Father, I command them to be established. Remember what I said, I am just a messenger. I release the message. What you do with the message is up to you. What you do with the message is up to you. God has spoken. Don't give up on yourself. Don't give up on your marriage. Don't give up on anything, because God has heard your cry. And God is saying, I'm coming back, and I'm going to bring you back to the place of joy, peace, and happiness. Because it is not over until I, God, says it is over. Anyone behind the scenes, Kabasikere, somebody is responsible. And I decree and I declare, anybody that wants to cause you pain in your own marital home, anybody that wants to cause you pain in your own marital home, may they drink their own poison in the name of Jesus. May they drink their own poison in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, anybody behind the scenes, whether you know or you don't know, I am telling you, don't be too complacent. It is not the will of God. Somebody is responsible. So never stop praying.
And make sure that ring in your finger, you don't remove it all. I hope that ring is still in your finger. Margaret, is that ring still on your finger? You did not make any mistake marrying. It is not a mistake. It is the devil fighting. And you must win. And you will win in the name of Jesus. These three things, I establish them in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. No matter how difficult the situation gets, let me tell you, you will laugh again. Margaret, you will laugh again. Margaret, God is going to restore you. Trust me. I know what I'm talking. It's coming from my spirit, man. You will laugh again. You will rejoice again. God is going to restore you. He said the years that the canker worm have eaten, the caterpillars, I shall restore in Jesus' name. You will see peace. You will see joy. And you will enjoy love in the name of Jesus. The devil is a liar. I restore back everything that you have stolen. And whoever that person is, they will not see peace in Jesus' name. Is Margaret there? Is Margaret there? It is done. It is done. Never ever remove your wedding ring. Not when you're cooking, not when you're showering, not when you're whatever you're doing, don't remove that ring from your finger. Because I saw that if you are not careful, you will take this ring out. Margaret Carvalho, are you on this live broadcast? Somebody call her back. Harriet, tell her not to remove that ring from her finger. I think Margaret is gone. But somebody pass on the message to her. Tell her not to remove it. Those of you that are married, fight for your marriage. Fight for your marriage. Don't let go easily. Don't. Unless and until it is abusive. Don't let go easily. When a man hits you, run. Don't even stay. I'm telling you today. Don't say, oh, well, he's going to change. Excuse me? They hit you once, they will hit you again. They will hit you again, no. They will hit you again, no. Tell her not to. Thank you, my prophetess. You have put a smile on my face today. Can somebody celebrate Jesus? Because you were not on my live broadcast. God said, bring her. Because she's on the verge of giving up. God said, don't give up, my darling. Do not give up, my darling. It's fine. Do not give up. Do not give up. Do not give up. Do not give up. My husband abandoned me for another woman. Please pray for me. Okay. There was somebody I saw, something Jawa. It's something Jawa. Something Jawa. The energy you have to use and enjoy your marriage, you use fighting. You won't give up. Matilda, no! No. Thank you, Prophetess C. I am very happy. I'm glad you're happy, Lena. And so shall it be for you for the rest of your life in Jesus' name. Amen. Everything will be okay, Lena, okay? Maria Gomez. I'm about to go now. Joseph Increase Jao. Is that Babio? Babio, is that you? Joseph Increase Jao. Is that you? I want to pray for you. I see an arrow thrown to your head. Yeah? Number one, I see you holding a microphone. Now, the microphone is not a microphone of singing. It is not of teaching, but it's a microphone to preach the word of God. Okay? It's a microphone to preach the word of God. This Joseph Increase Jao. Joseph Increase Jao. I saw a mic in your hand. And God said, I have made you a preacher.
I don't know what you do, because you know Gambia, a lot of us are Catholic, so it's like, you know, we give God glory for that. But I said the other day, God is gonna raise prophets and prophetesses and teachers and preachers, because there is going to be a revival in Gambia that will shock the nations. Okay, God is raising giants in the kingdom that will bring revival in Gambia. And you, this favored Jawa guy, if nobody has told you, I'm telling you today, you are meant to be a preacher. I don't know what you do. I don't know what church you go. I don't even know if you are a Christian. But whatever it is, God has called you to preach the gospel. God has called you. I'm a minister, ma'am. You are a minister. Do you preach? You preach. He is a minister. You are a minister in a church. Let me tell you something. You, God is going to use you. I preach. Can somebody celebrate Jesus? God is going to use you. God is going to open your eyes. There's some altars in your family. I won't say what side of your family. May God show you, if God has not showed you anyway. Because, yes, I preach in Cyprus. My God, you are in Cyprus? Oh, wow. Oh, wow. You are in Cyprus? Let me tell you something. You are not just going to preach. There's a healing grace over your life, number one. And you are going to prophesy. God is going to open your eyes and you're going to start seeing things about people. And God is telling me to tell you, be bold and be brave to speak when God speaks to you about people. Because you are not just going to preach or teach, you're going to prophesy and you're going to heal and you're going to deliver. I see you laying hands on the sick and they are healed. I see you laying hands on people that are bound and they're delivered. I see you speaking into lives and there is manifestations and confirmations. I see you literally, let me tell you something. There are things that you must break in your family. May God reveal to you so you know what side of your family, whether it's daddy family or mother family. Let me just be discreet here. I don't know why God is telling me not to say what side of the family it is, so I will not say. But there are altars you must deal with in your family. There is a side of your family that is a bit dark. And God is saying, I have raised you as a prophet to the to this generation. And I want you to deal with certain altars. He said, I know. Glory be to God. I'm done. I'm not going to go any deep. Thank God God has revealed it to you. Let me tell you something. A time is coming. You, this young man, you will go back to Gambia and you will hold a crusade. I don't know if you've ever thought of that, because a time is coming. You yourself and a group of people from where you are, and you will organize another group in Gambia where you will travel back to Gambia and you will hold a crusade. You will hold a crusade where Muslims would give their lives to Christ. Those that are bound will be delivered. Those that are sick will be healed. And you will speak the undiluted word of God. God has anointed you from birth. God himself has anointed you from your mother's womb. You are a gift to your mother. You are a gift and a blessing to your mother. And I pray for you today. May the oil of God over your life never run dry. I pray that may God take you to the next dimension of the prophetic, to the next dimension of healing and deliverance, to the next dimension of teaching in the name of Jesus. I have been doing for 6 years. What have you been doing for 6 years? This guy is anointed. I don't know who knows this Joseph Increase Jawa. This guy is... You are going... You are going to make news for good reasons. What have you been doing for 6 years? How come I don't know you like this? But thank God for connection. I thank God that you came into this life. When I'm ready to travel to Gambia, you'll be part of the troop. Kabasikede. What have you been doing for 6 years, please? Thank you. pray for you as well. Anything to do with your head. Holding crusade in Gambia before I left. Wow! 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 You've held a crusade in Gambia before you left? Nah, man. God can't lie. I don't know this young man. I can't wait to see you in Gambia. I am coming. He holds crusades in Gambia before I left. Jesus is Lord. Can we celebrate what God is doing in Gambia? Who would have thought? Can we celebrate what God is doing in Gambia? There is a generation coming up. God is raising a generation that will set Gambia on fire for Jesus. Somebody remember this word very well. God is going to set Gambia on fire for Jesus. And God has selected individuals that would literally spearhead this move. There is a move about to take place. There is a move that is about to shake the shores of Gambia. Something is about to happen and Gambia will not be the same again. May the oil of God over your life never run dry, Princess Jawa. Please, if we're going to Gambia, back to broadcast and inform Prophetess T so that we'll be part of the delegation. Please, anytime you are ready to do your crusade in Gambia again, Princess Jawa, anytime you're ready to do your crusade, please let me know. We are a family here. You let us know way in advance and we will storm the land. We will storm the land. If we have to go and come back the following day, we will go and do the job and come back. Wherever God sends us, we are going. Wherever God sends us, we are going. There's a shaking in Gambia for a reason. Whatever is going on in Gambia right now, God is doing something behind the scenes. And he's saying that I'm raising the same people that came out of this land to come back and deliver this land. Yes, she has found a general. God ever bless you. So anytime you are ready for a crusade, whether it's going to be yours before mine, I don't know. But anytime you're ready to do this crusade, let me tell you something. You are not alone. Princess Jawa. Is that the name? I forget the name again. Something Jawa. You are not alone. Joseph Jawa. You are not alone anymore. Anytime you make up your mind, anytime you make up your mind to do so, let us know. Okay, send me a DM, please. God bless you. Send me a DM. God bless you. There is a prayer mantle over your life as well. Prayer mantle. I want you to pray. God is going to lay in your heart. Joseph Jawa, God is going to lay in your heart, yeah, to do like a live broadcast of prayer where you just do a live broadcast and it's going to be a prayer live broadcast. Yeah, it's going to be a prayer live broadcast. God is going to lay it in your hand. When that time comes, go ahead. Whether it's going to be on Facebook, whatever platform it's going to be, go ahead and do it. Because God is going to use you mightily. Because of you, those that doubted God will run to God. Because of you, those that doubted prophecy. You guys, mark my words. We will all hear about this young man here in the name of Jesus. I am so happy. A lot of you are watching me on this live broadcast. The Lord has been telling me but been delaying. God, can somebody celebrate the prophetic grace of God in this house? He said, God has been telling, no more delay, Joseph. No more delay. Go ahead. This is a confirmation. No more delay. For God to use me to reveal it to you again is a confirmation. No more delay. Rise up. Put yourself together. And speak the word of God, because you are a giant in the kingdom. A giant in the kingdom. And anything that rises up from your family to stop you from walking in that calling, today I break it in Jesus' name. Nothing will stop you. Nobody will stop you. No altar from any side of your family will stop you in the name of Jesus. You are lifted in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for representing Gambia in Cyprus. God bless you. Cyprus, God bless you. God bless you for being a voice at a young age. God bless you. God will use you mightily in the name of Jesus.
Now I'm going to take testimonies. I got to go. Time is gone. So tomorrow I'll be here at 8. So tomorrow is 8. You all know Monday, I start a bit late, either from 9 or 9:30. So Monday is not 8 because of what I have to do. Tomorrow I will have to leave early because I have an appointment. So I made sure that the appointment is after my live broadcast. But tomorrow by 9:30, I have to leave the live broadcast. So if you don't come in on time, I will finish because I will do the prophetic declaration. Pam, 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 pam. We will pray. Pam, 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 pam. I will use the prayer points. Pam, pam. And I'm gone because I have an appointment. I gotta go. So, you guys, tomorrow I'll be here 8 to 9. And then Wednesday is on Instagram, not on Facebook. I'm not sure if I will do Instagram. But just sometimes I will not advertise. I will just show up. I don't know why. Just, you know, I still put my finger in the glass. Put it there. Don't remove it. Put it there, Elena. Something is happening. Something is happening in that finger of yours that you put in the water. Something is happening. Something is breaking. So I'm going to invite Harriet Jammeh for her testimony. Don't go anywhere. It's good to hear testimonies because they encourage you. And then after the testimony, we're going to pray over our prayer points. And then we call it a day till tomorrow. Harriet Jammeh, can you send me... Where is Favor Chan? If you don't show your face, I will close the line. Show your face, so. Let's hear this testimony. Our mind is still in the glass, prophetess. I did not ask you to put your finger in the glass. I only asked one person to put their finger in the glass. Somebody tap into the prophecy and also put their finger in the glass. Oh, well, I'll pray for you, NK, okay? Okay, Harriet, I think it declined, so let's try again. Let's hear this testimony to the glory of God. Harriet Carvalho's testimony was so powerful. Harriet Carvalho, I need to bring you on the live to share your testimony, please. Is Harriet Carvalho there? There are weddings, so there are weddings coming. I hear wedding bells all over the place. But on this platform, there's going to be weddings, marriages upon marriages. The devil is a liar. Does anyone have a jammer to come? Father, bring Harriet on in Jesus' name. Amen. Prophetess, Isaiah said you have new hair. It's nice. Oh, thank you, Isaiah. Thank you. So Harriet Carvalho, tomorrow you make your face nice so you come and share your testimony. Harriet, what's going on? He's still saying adding. Oh God. So tomorrow Harriet, hey Benny's, how are you? I haven't seen you for a long time. Oh no, Harriet Jammeh can't come on the lives. What's happening? Harriet, are you coming on? I need to see your face. You don't go to Pastor Jerry's life and hide your face. He will not take you on. So Harriet, if you are not showing your face, me, I don't care if your face is wrong. Come on, Harriet Jammeh, my bishopess. Come on. Chantelle, everybody. Whilst we wait on Harriet. Okay, let me ask Suntu. Suntu, you gotta show your face, please. Suntu, send your invite. Let's share the testimony for Suntu. Okay, let me try Harriet again and then soon to later. But there's a testimony I want to read, so hear me out. Oh. I did send the request. Oh God, what's going on? Oh. Don't go away. Hear the testimony and tap into it as well. I'm trying to invite. Okay. I sent a request to Suntu as well. So let me just share this testimony before they come on. It says, testimony, testimony, testimony. 23rd June, I sent a prayer request for a favor to get a full scholarship to enable me study in September 2022. That was on the 23rd of June. She sent a prayer request. On the 28th of June, I received an offer for a 12-month stipend scholarship. The approval came from someone I never expected. I'm saying this because this guy stopped talking to me for reasons best known to himself. I was shocked when I received news that he approved my request for sponsorship. This can only be God. Did you guys hear that testimony? She sent a prayer request on the 23rd of June. June gone. On the 28th of June, her prayers got answered. She got the scholarship from someone that she least expected. Listen, let me tell you something. If God is ready to bless you here, he can use your haters to bless you. They don't have a choice, but they will bless you. They don't have a choice, but they must open that door. That is the God that we serve. 23rd of June, prayer request. 28th of June, request answered. Done. This is God. If your God is dead, my one is alive. We celebrate with you, Flourish Sambu. May testimonies never cease from your home. In the name of Jesus. I don't know why Harriet Jame and Suntu can come on the lives. This is beyond me. I don't understand. Unable to add requests. I don't know what's going on. So Harriet, can you send again? Because I've just testimony, and I prophesy over everybody watching me right now. May testimonies not cease from your home. May God give you a reason to celebrate, to testify, and to dance this year in the mighty name of Jesus. You might have cried from January till now. You might have gone through hardship and headache and troubles of life from January till now, but I've come to let you know, according to the word of God, it too shall pass. According to the word of God, after you have cried for a while, after you have suffered for a while, after you have gone through trials and tribulations for a while, after you have been rejected for a while, God is about to perfect you. God is about to establish you. God is about to strengthen you. And God is about to settle you. In the name of Jesus. I don't know why this request is not going. It says adding. Harriet, are you there? Unbelievable. I added Suntu, nothing. I added Harriet, nothing. So I'm so confused right now. I cannot add them. Let me try again. Amen. Gabriel Gomez, Gabriel Correa, I hear God saying, I've done a few things for you and you haven't testified. I don't know why God is saying that. God is saying that I have done a few things for you, but you feel like they are not too big for you to testify. God says you are sitting on testimonies. I don't know why. And God says you must release those testimonies because there are more testimonies coming. Harriet, maybe come out of the live and come back and see. Let me try soon too. Gabriel said, yes, true. I heard it clearly. God said, I have done a few things for you, but you have not been grateful by testifying. And so you're holding on to many more testimonies. You overcome by your testimonies and by the blood of the Lamb. So anytime God does something for you, no matter how little it is, you must testify. When you are in the habit of testifying, you never stop testifying. It's a secret that people don't get. Anytime God does something for you, you must testify, because there's a testimony that is coming your way, Gabriel Correa. I heard God say there's a testimony. Then God said, I have done few things for him and he hasn't testified. Maybe because Harriet is not using iPhone. You gotta testify, Gabriel Correa. You gotta testify and shame the devil for more testimonies to flow. I don't know what's going on. It keeps saying adding, and it's not adding. So I don't know. Maybe Harriet and Suntu, you come out of the life and come back on again. Maybe that will work. I don't know. This is crazy. This has never happened.
This has never happened. Let me ask Suntu again. Let me try Suntu. Bear with me, guys. We're gonna go in the next 2 minutes. If not, we will try again tomorrow. But it's not allowing them. You have to testify, Gabriel. You have to testify. Everything that God done for you, you gotta testify. The more you give God thanks for what He's done, the more He does more in your life. So unfortunately, I can't add this beautiful lady. So let's pray over our... Okay, let me try Matilda. Matilda says unable to add. They can't join your broadcast at this time. Why? How? What kind of rubbish is this? I don't know. It says you guys can't join my broadcast. I tried to add Matilda, and it's just telling me they can't join your live broadcast at this time. Yeah. Connection failed. Yeah, it's not happening. So tomorrow we try. I don't know why. Lift your prayer points, please. Let's pray. If you're new on this live broadcast, what we do every day that we're on here, we pray over our prayer points. So we started in February, I think, or so. You write something down that you want God to do for you. I always say, even though you've written from February till now and God has not yet answered you, what did I say? Yet answered you. You don't stop praying. Keep repeating the same prayers over and over again. God will shock you. Amen. Lift your prayer points up. Lena, I have not forgotten you. I'm coming. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we lift our prayer points up, we want to thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the opportunity to come before you, O God, to lift our petitions before you and made our requests known unto you, O God. Father, Lord, we lift our prayer points in faith. There are more than one, more than two, more than three, more than four. Some of us is the same prayer point. Some of us is different prayer points. Father, I pray, O God, as you have done it for people on this live broadcast, may you do it for each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. Father, I decree and I declare, may every prayer point that is written down be answered in the name of Jesus. Let every prayer point that is written down turn into testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and I declare each and every one of us on this live broadcast will testify to the glory of your name that you indeed have done for us. In Jesus' name, amen. You open your prayer point and just thank God for what you have written. If it's six, mention each and every one of them and say thank you. If it's six prayer points about marriage, thank you, Lord, for my marriage. Thank you, Lord, for my marriage. If it's for the fruit of the womb, thank you, Lord, for the fruit of whatever you have written. Mention it and thank God for it. If you felt any burning sensation whilst your hand was on the water, don't be discouraged. Something is happening. God is doing something. As you have removed your hand from that water that was torn into the blood of Jesus, that cleanses, that heals, that restores, I decree and I declare, as the ring has been removed from your hand, I command you to go and enjoy your marriage. I decree and I declare, as that ring has been removed from your hand, go and carry your own children. Any hold on your womb today, it is broken in the name of Jesus. As God did it for Hannah, He will do it for you. As God did it for Elizabeth, He will do it for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Just start rejoicing, Lena. Anytime you wake up, just say, Lord, thank you for my children. Not child, children. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you all. I'm gonna go now. I was meant to give a word to Maria Gomez, but tomorrow I will do so. I was meant to give a word to something Loom, something L-U-M-B. I couldn't because of time. So tomorrow you'll be the first two people I will minister to. Marie Loom, I think it's Marie something Loom, and then Maria Gomez. I had a word for Marie Kumba Gomez, so tomorrow I will do so. So Marie Kumba Gomez, Maria Gomez, and Marie Loom would be the first people I'll minister to tomorrow, and then we will continue. Ellen Pender, I hope you're enjoying.
Yes, just throw the water away. Throw the water away. Throw the water away.
So, God bless you guys. I'm back again tomorrow morning. Tomorrow is going to be 8 to 9. So, tomorrow is 8 to 9. Wednesday is Instagram, hopefully, I'm not sure. Thursday, back again. Friday, back again. So God bless you guys. Thank you for being here today. And I prophesy over the 50 people that are on this live broadcast and the rest of you on YouTube. May God come through for you at the point of your need. Nen B, I hope you did the same thing as you also tapped into the prophetic word. I decree and I declare the hold on your marriage is over. In the name of Jesus, amen. Thank you, everybody. Hi, Nafi Koka, it's good to see you. Thank you all, and may you all have a God day. May you all have a God day. Marifun, I pray for you. May God come through for you in the name of Jesus. May God heal you from every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. You're not going to die before your time, Marifun. I decree and I declare whatever you're going through right now. Did I ask you to do something, Marifun? I pray for you today. Can you get a water? Can you get a bottle of water, a glass of water, Marifun or Marifun? Sorry if I'm calling your name wrong. Marifun, do you want to get a bottle of water, please? I want to pray for that water. Oh, I know, Marifun. I know. You were sleeping with my dad, Ida. It's Ida, right? Ida. Get a cup of water. Get a cup of water. I'm gonna pray for you, and you're gonna drink that water, and that water is gonna flush out anything in your system that is not of God in the name of Jesus. Every pain that you're encountering right now, every sickness, after you drink this water, everything is coming out in Jesus' name. You are healed in the name of Jesus. Mary Ann Food. It's not Ida. Okay, I'm wrong. That's not you. Is that Ida or not? So get a glass of water quickly. Get a glass of water. And I stand in the gap for everyone here that's also sick. That's also sick, as I do it for Mary Ann Food. I also decree and declare, let the same healing grace visit you in the mighty name of Jesus. Mary Ann Fun, get the glass of water. Let me know you got it so I can pray for you before I go. You got the water. Father, in the name of Jesus, I lift your daughter before you. This water turns into the healing balm of Gilead. As she drinks this water, I decree and I declare, let anything and everything in her system causing her pain be flushed out in the name of Jesus. I command you healed and whole in the mighty name of Jesus. I command you healed and whole in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you all. The CYM 1 year anniversary is in December 7th. I don't know what date is that. December 7th is our 1 year anniversary. So I'm trying to do like a one-day prayer event. You can come and go home the same day. It's not going to be all night or anything. We're just probably going to stay. I can't do all night because some of you live far. So all night wouldn't be fair. But I don't know what I'm going to do. But it's going to be a prayer session. Both me and my husband will be there. Y'all all know that. I can't do without my husband. He got to be there. So it's going to be a one-day prayer fest, okay? It's going to be a one-day prayer marathon, not even prayer fest. It's going to be a one-day prayer marathon, yeah? Prayer marathon to mark our anniversary, okay? We're going to pray like crazy. We're going to pray like crazy. Pray like crazy. So I'm going to come up with a date. Our anniversary is in December. I didn't even know we started in December. I thought we started in February. It's going to be in December. So please, when I come tomorrow, I will finalize the date with my husband. We'll try and do it in December where there's a holiday, where some of you will not have to go back. You'll not be worrying about going back to work. So we're going to do it on a day where everybody is available. And it's going to be a whole day of prayer, power manifestation, deliverance, prophecy. Listen, it's going to be crazy. So we're celebrating 1 year of the goodness of God on CYM. So I'll put the dates here, and please, you guys must show up. It's just 1 day. It's not 3 days like the WOP conference. And I'll also release the dates for the WOP conference for next year. I will release it this year so everybody's ready. You guys see that person behind me? I don't know what she's doing. You want to say hi? So, you just want to watch. Where is the calendar? The 7th of December, what day is that, please? Can somebody help me? The 7th of December. Where is the student, Matilda? Hi, Isaiah. Isaiah, they said hi. When is the 7th of December? As I said hi back in a very cheeky way. It's on a Wednesday. What day should the conference be? What day should it be? I wanna get people's what day should we have the conference? I think Saturday would be good. Yeah, I saw your comment, Harriet. I see. Secretary has answered. What day should we have our 1 year anniversary? I think Saturday would be good. Saturday would be good. So for some of you, you come the weekend, you do Saturday and Sunday, you come to church. Yeah, I think Saturday would be a good day. Friday or Saturday would be best. Saturday is best. So let's say Saturday. The Saturday after the 7th of December. What day is that? Secretary, what date is that? Saturday, okay. The Saturday after the 7th of December. What Saturday is? Matilda says Saturday. What day is that? This is for every CYM member and even outsiders. So it's not just for us. It's for everybody. So I'm going to do like an Eventbrite again just to have an idea of how many people are coming so I know what place to book. So the 10th of December. Is that a good day? 10th of December, is that a good day? It's just a whole day of prayer. We're literally coming to pray. Non-stop prayer. And we're fasting on that day as well. We're going to end that. Listen, that's an opportunity to end the year well and start the next year well. 10th of December. 10th of December is going to be our 1 year CYM anniversary. 10th of December. 10th of December. 10th of December. So you guys keep that in your diaries. It's going to be on a Saturday. And I think schools will be closed by then. Even if schools are not closed, it's Saturday, so it should be okay. Schools will be closed by then. I'm not sure. Zaya, when does school close in December? 17th. Oh, schools close from the 17th, as I said. Zaya, volume down. So is the 10th okay, or should we do it when schools close? What should we do? Is the 10th okay, or should we do it in the week the school closed? What do you guys think? Because it's one day, you guys can even come with your children. There's Sunday school. So should we stick to the 10th? Yeah, I'll speak to me. Okay. Somebody say it's fine. So I think the 10th is fine. Because it's just one day anyway. So it's just when school closed. Okay, somebody say when school closed. Somebody said 10th. Nafi Koka said when school closed. Prophetess, some people might be going to Gambia for Christmas. Ooh. Like you, yeah. Maria Gomez, it looks like you're going to Gambia. So the 10th is better, yeah. Early December is better because late December people might be traveling. Is that what you're saying? The semesters are storming Gambia, eh? 10th is fine. So let's do 10th. Nafi Koka, you should try and come to this one. It's going to be on a Saturday, so you can come and go back the same day. It's not going to be an all-night thing. So, you know, you can always go back and catch your train. So you just make sure you book a late train or you stay in a hotel and come to church on Sunday. Harry Ajame, that day you are not going home. You will sleep here and come to church on Sunday. Maria Gomez and Matilda Gomez, they live around, so... The 10th. So let's say the 10th, because the 17th might be too risky. Some people will be making their minds up to travel for holidays and the Christmas. So 10th of December, CYM 1 year anniversary. 10th of December. So I think we should have t-shirts, right? I think we should have CYM t-shirts. Yeah, we should have CYM t-shirts. I'll make sure the t-shirts come out early so everybody can get theirs. So the 10th of December deal. Okay, deal. CYM 1 year anniversary is a day of prayer where we literally surrender to God and usher ourselves into 2023. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus' name. Yes, Harriet always takes the final blessing. You're wise. You're wise. So Nafi Koka, try and see how best you can make it, because I know you couldn't make it to that WOP conference. So hopefully the 1 year anniversary you come. So I'll also fix the date for the WOP conference for next year. Amen. So God bless you all. Love you all with the love of God. Those who are not here, let them know about the dates so they can make time to come. Those of you in America, you might not be able to show. I don't know if you can. That would be great. But for the next WOP conference, you guys have to show up. So God bless you all. Love you all with the love of God. May you all have a G-O-D day. May you all have a G-O-D day in the name of Jesus. And see you all tomorrow morning from 8 to 9, maybe 9:20, because by 9:30 I have to leave my house. So love you all. We will have t-shirts for the conference. I don't know what color we will have for the t-shirts. We will decide. We have some nice t-shirts that we're going to wear on that day. So we are all in one, in unity, and in just in oneness. So we will have t-shirts that will be sold just for £20. Is it £20 or £25? I'm not sure. £20, £25, depends. So you have enough time to save £5 a day or £5 a week, so you can have your t-shirts sorted. So start saving your £1 a day for the t-shirts. Okay? So God bless you all. Love you all with the love of God. And on that day, you know, I'll also have a special gift for every Commanding Your Morning, family member. There's something special I will also release to you guys on that day. I don't know what it is or whatever it is. You guys will leave with something from me to you, just saying thank you for your love, for your support, and for your everything. In Jesus' name, amen. £1 a week for your t-shirt, you'll be fine. For December, we are in August. For December, you'll be fine. For your £20 t-shirt or £25, I know, it depends on the cost of the t-shirt. So God bless you all, love you all, have a good day, and I'll see you all tomorrow in the name of Jesus. Stay blessed, stay empowered, and keep winning. In Jesus' name, amen. Ciao. Goodbye. The 10th of December, it is, wow. God bless you guys. Everybody on YouTube, thank you for joining me today. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. YouTube, Facebook, I love you all. Stay blessed and have a good day. Have a G-O-D day in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye. I'll be sharing the testimonies today, so I'm back to sharing testimonies. So when you see the testimony, share, comment, like, say something. In Jesus' name. Amen. Bye. Is that how you can play? Oops.